Hello again! Today we're going to have a look at how to style widgets in Axure. To edit the styles of a widget, look at the right column on the interface and inside the inspector, click on the Style tab. The Style tab contains almost every styling option you will ever need. The first fields allow you to define exactly the position of a widget with X and Y coordinates, its width and its height. The small checkbox between the width and the height allow you to determine if the aspect ratio of the widget should be kept the same or not. Just below, you can edit the rotation of the widget itself and of the text, for example, if you want the rectangle to be slightly slanted but the text to remain straight, it's useful to have both fields. The next two items allow you to flip your widget vertically or horizontally. This will basically make them appear as a mirrored image of themselves. Clicking the last two icons will adjust the width or the height of the widget to whatever text it contains, so that will fit exactly to the content. You can customize the background color of a widget with the Fill field. When you click the drop-down on the right, a color picker will appear, and you can choose either one plain color or multiple colors that will appear as a gradient. You can also add a shadow to a widget. When you click on the shadow option, you can check a box to activate the shadow. The offset will determine whether the shadow will be right behind or directed towards the bottom or one of the sides of the widget, and the blur will determine how large it will be. You can also pick a color if you want to give it a nice hue or just adjust its opacity. As you notice, there are two buttons for shadows. The first one will determine a shadow outside of the widget, and the second one will determine a shadow on the inside. You can customize the look of the borders of your widgets as well. You can adjust the width, the color, and give the borders a style such as dotted or dashed, for example. It's also possible to display only some of the borders, so for example, this option would allow you to highlight a quote with a line on the left. Finally, you'll also use the border options to customize lines that you drew. So for example, if you made an arrow, the last drop down here would allow you to pick the style of the arrowhead. The corner radius option lets you define what angle the corners of your widgets should be rounded. And the drop-down next to it allows you to decide whether all the corners should be rounded or just some of them. Now let's scroll down a little and have a look at the rest of the options. You may have noticed the background color of a widget can be partly translucent. So you may wonder why there is a separate opacity option. The opacity defines the transparency of the whole widget, including its borders and the text it may contain. So you may want to use this instead if you want to create a nice see-through effect or if you want to make the whole widget translucent. And now for some typography. Axure allows you to pick a custom font. The font will be displayed if the user has his font locally on their computer, but you can also configure web fonts. We'll talk about that much later on. You can use the different styles of the fonts and edit the size. And of course, you can use the buttons below to change it to bold, italics, underlined. Unfortunately, there's no options for things like strike through. You can also change the color of the font and add a shadow to it, just the same way you would add a shadow to a widget. The line spacing or line height defines the white space that will be in between multiple lines of text on a single widget. By default, if it is not set, the line height will depend on the font size, but if you change it, you can reduce or make the space wider. Be careful if you change the font size afterwards, that it doesn't look weird. Axure has an option to add bullets to text. This will just add a single bullet in front of every new line. Finally, you can align text. You can align it horizontally or vertically in any way you want. But you cannot justify text. Finally, padding defines the white space that will be between the edges of the widget, or the borders if you prefer, and the place where text will begin. So this would basically be similar to a padding in HTML. But if you're not familiar with that, it doesn't really matter for now. Just remember that this is the option to use instead of having a text widget on top of a rectangle. Write on the rectangle directly and use padding to define those white spaces. It'll make your prototype a lot easier to handle. Alright, so now that we've covered all the styling options, almost. This was a long list and there's a lot of stuff to take in, so just play around with it, get familiar with the different styles and options, and we'll see each other next time. Let me know how it goes!